Gaming, there's been a win for them in this series already. They just have to look back to game one and find out what went right for them. A few different bans coming out, more of what we saw in game one. We'll see if the Karma is the final one for Immortals to round out exactly what they had coming out of game two.
They have to ban
Vladimir as well.
I think they have to ban Vladimir.
Right, that last ban. Too important to have.
Yeah.
God, you're a mind reader. Did you take Jad's crystal ball?
Oh, well, they will first pick Karma.
We'll see. HuHi on Karma's provided so much utility to the team as well. Keeping his wave cleared in the mid lane, allowing every...
Wrong.
Like we said, if the Azir's up, that is the most blind pick we'd see in mid lane.
I was actually just looking at the bans from game one. It was Rumble, Aurelia, Olaf, same. And then it was Vladimir, Ryze, Azir. So the Azir is the one that dropped off.
Yeah.
So CLG are trading Azir for Karma. It's going to be really interesting here because I believe this allows you to play a lot of different things. They won't have the Vladimir, but they will have the Karma. And I think you also pick the rek'sai here just because it's so early on.
Also being able to get Reignover into the fights is huge.
Yeah, and I think that Immortals need to calm down with their pick ban because before they were picking Huni's champion super early, right? Yeah, you did it. Huni's champion really early in the top lane. It's something that they weren't doing almost at all in the spring split. So now, I assume that they last pick it here. You have to wait for it. You know the Azir's going mid. You should see what Darshan is going to play.
Well, I think it definitely helps and hurts CLG. The Jax banned by Immortals is going to help them. The fact that they have to ban the Aurelia as well. We heard Azale and Dash talking about it. Get him back on something that can carry that game. Looks like they are going to leave Darshan up for the end as well. Azir to the mid lane, Bard to the bot, and Xmithie will be taking that Gragas most likely.
Yeah, so you take Viktor, and you take whatever AD carry you want here. I definitely think the Viktor goes over. Since the Vladimir is not there, it's a great consistent wave clear mid, especially against Azir. You have some kill potential, but honestly, finding your way in becomes very difficult later on in the game.
And Pobelter knows that Viktor, three straight games of it against TSM when he was on CLG. So why not in the finals? He knows exactly what to do with his lasers. Oh, even more lasers.
The counter matchup. If he goes for it.
What will he decide? The Taliyah hover?
How do you fight walls with other walls?
Not sure if that works.
But baited.
Viktor's going to be locked in. He wasn't worried about it. Aphromoo, good guy, playing to the crowd once again. As they all cheered, please pick Teemo support this series.
Yeah, he's done it all three games in terms of hovering it, so.
Well, is he going to man up?
And Stixxay's always going to hover the Warwick.
Of course.
Used to be a Warwick one trick back
what
in the day.
What would you always hover? I would always hover Kennen, obviously. Oh,
I'd probably hover Jarvan.
Yeah, I like it. Right?
I'd probably be like Jarvan, then Rammus, then Skarner, just because.
Ray's like, I like that pick. What will CLG round this one out with? Like we said, they like to drain that clock down to not give Immortals too much time to think about that last thought. I mean, they still get 60 seconds, but you're just trying to put that pressure on them as much as you can.
Yeah, you're hoping for the Caitlyn here if you're a CLG fan because it's a champion that Stixxay, you know, he showed that he could play. And
yeah.
Honestly, kind of schooling the world at MSI.
The request from the desk as well. They would like to see the Caitlyn. They'd like to see those champions he brought out. He hovered the Jhin coming into, I believe it was game one. And we are actually going to get that Jhin in game three, along with the Fiora in the top lane. One of the other ones that we heard from the analyst desk that Darshan might want to jump to keep that pressure in the top lane.
Yeah, Fiora took nerfs a long time ago, and then they changed that you can't swap out Titanic and Ravenous Hydra. So her curve got kind of worse in the early game. But the reduction in the cost of Black Cleaver made it so that when she gets the two items, it's a little bit sooner, it's a little bit better for her. So she's in a better spot now. And then Jhin, I'm interested to see what build Stixxay goes for here because of the buffs to damage on IE and Essence Reaver, people have been going with that. But before 6/12, I was seeing a lot of this armor penetration build. It's incredibly powerful. Jhin crits automatically on every fourth shot, right? So he basically has 25% crit chance for all intents and purposes. And then Critical Strike isn't worth as much on him in a way because you only really affect three of your shots.
Right.
So armor penetration was like, hey, I automatically crit. Let's make it crit even harder.
Seems like it'll be an interesting composition. Everybody wants to go in for CLG, and it seems like Stixxay's Jhin will be that enabler, that lockdown, and then the follow-up damage from that curtain call. On the other side, a whole lot of damage to be thrown out in a nice ability power comp once again. Pretty much chock full of ability power.
Yeah, it's relatively close to the composition they had last game in terms of what they want to accomplish. Mm-hmm. Pobelter will try to run straight through the team, has the ghost to do so, try to skirt around the edges. He'll try to actually throw his ultimate down. And once he has Rylai's and his completely upgraded Hex Core, he'll be in a fantastic spot to slow people down with the Chaos Storm. And then they have ways to get in, too, now that they have the Karma on their side for Immortals. And Huni, you know, his split push is going to be much weaker this game, especially against that Fiora. But he's looking for those team fights. He's looking for the flanks.
It's basically what solidified the deal last time. We saw the deep wards that Huni was leaving up for himself, and it allowed them the backline to get to Stixxay. Now on Jhin this game, going to be even less mobile than his previous picks of Caitlyn, Lucian, Ezreal. It's going to be a tough game for the backline of CLG here. Send us now into the deciding game in this match by contributing your opinions to the fan vote. Hit us up on Twitter with the hashtag CLGWin or the hashtag IMTWin as we finalize one of our Friday night series here as we get into Game 3. There's more League after this. Don't go anywhere, but we are going to see who takes this one between Counter Logic Gaming and Immortals. We'll swap sides one more time with CLG on the blue again and Immortals back to the red side. We are on to the Rift, and we are into game point for both teams.
And this is why we play BO3s, because that first game was CLG. Looked rather convincing, right?
Right.
Game 2, Immortals come back even faster.
Jinx.
Nice. That's the synergy. We're on it for game 3. But game 3, Immortals, they're going back to a little bit of what they know, mm-hmm. what worked for them, the backline access. We're able to work around all of those top lane bans, and Darshan still finding a split pusher for himself. And that's what I'm really interested in, is that top lane as well as this mid lane, because Pobelter's got the better of this matchup every single game so far and has been incredibly consistent. And Darshan, well, last game was relatively awful for him after the lane swap. Like Azale was saying, down 70 CS, wasn't able to answer right. the split push. But on Fiora, if he gets going, he's going to become basically unstoppable.
We've seen it a few times already played in the LCS. Fiora did control the top lane quite well. We'll just have to see how that matchup plays out again. Remembering our featured matchup within these teams is between Xmithie and Reignover. Reignover has seemed to get the best of both games so far, even in CLG's win. Yeah. Very strong on controlling that blue away from HuHi and triple buffing the start.
Yeah, he also had a very quick jungle due to the assistance of Huni, and Huni not taking any of the experience.
A little help from wildturtle as well in the wolf camp. So they're trying a few different things. They're not lying. They are experimenting.
Mm-hmm.
A few things here and there in the beginning may seem like they fizzle out. But if they work in the beginning and they're acted on by Immortals, you usually see them get quite a lead. Doesn't seem like we'll get any of that trickery in the beginning of this one. Junglers with the top laners, and we are going to get that lane swap.
Hmm. Kind of lazy wards there from CLG. I'm trying to see what happened. Because they didn't have one...
Right, to identify around blue buff somewhere.
Yeah, they didn't have one blue buff. Oh, yeah, they put one in the middle of the lane, and Pobelter could still see it. So they put it in the mid lane to try and block that, but Pobelter just walks up and kills it. So they were able to see and opt into this. Didn't want to go against the Jhin and the Bard.
Oh, hello.
And shut down the Fiora a little bit. Like, Fiora definitely needs more gold than Lissandra to be relevant.
That's a really good point. That could actually really hurt Darshan in this. We know Huni to be somebody that can win their lane, one, by just out-dueling their opponent, and then two, if he has the lane lead, he knows how to control those waves.
Mm-hmm.
Huni can beat somebody more than not just by that wave control, and here they're going to be onto the turret immediately. Again, getting a bit faster timing, but we're not seeing the teleport from Darshan here. He's trying to stay in range. I did not think that was going to kill him. I apologize. That was terrible on me. I thought he was going to get away.
No.
But flash forward. It just seems so easy for them. Who he had nothing to do.
Yeah, again, Pobelter gets the better of the matchup. Reignover with the super early gank. That's a pre-3-minute gank there. The tunnel, flash onto the Azir. He knows he's not level 3, so he has Sand Soldier, and then he also has Conquering Sands, not shifting to get away, so he has to blow his own flash. But then Pobelter realizes, hey, I've got enough to kill him, and uses the combo, lands every little bit of it.
I'm just like, oh, nothing's gonna happen here. Flash, shift out, he'll be good. Takes him down immediately. So already Immortals making it hurt for Counter Logic Gaming. and really kind of putting it in their court of what are you going to do next? How do you play off of this? Because Immortals is not going to stop.
Yeah, and it may get even worse too because it's a rek'sai, right? So Reignover is able to actually hand off the blue buff super early if he wants to and give it to Pobelter.
So Chronologic Gaming.
Oh man. Yep. Pobelter gets to come back with an upgrade already. Very early on, gets the death ray. So his wave clear right now, he can keep shoving in and actually denying CS from HuHi. I had to stop myself there. I almost said Huni.
It'll happen. Just let it happen. HuHi will come back. He's going to have a hard time. Like we said, his objective has been to clear waves, keep Pobelter down, but it looks like Pobelter is going to get some free time now if he can keep pressuring this. And it's going to be the comeback attack.
No flash.
There's the field. He actually shifts out of it immediately. HuHi could really keep himself alive here, but he stays in for too many autos, knowing Xmithie and Aphromoo are just around the bend, trying to clean up a kill of their own. And the assist could be huge. It's going to be the meep coming through. To get a bop onto Reignover. They do get the one kill and the assist goal to HuHi finally.
Yeah, and they get the kill back, but still, HuHi really far behind now.
Right. Down. The rinse and repeat is hurting him a lot.
Oh, yeah. The kill up for Pobelter, the first blood, and the fact that that's also an assist that's split three ways, because assist gold is the same no matter what.
Right.
And then it gets split between those people, so it becomes kind of chump change for him. Has to shift forward because he was going to get knocked up inside of the gravity field. Aphromoo gets stunned, gets picked up, and Xmithie was already on his way, and Pobelter pops the ghost because he thinks that he's the one that's going to get engaged on, but ooh, Aphromoo a little bit too far forward here.
He's using the minions.
He's looking for a stun point.
He's got the minion cavalry. Darshan, oh, Darshan. He tried to use him as the meat shield. Darshan as well stepped in front to try and take it. He parries back to Turtle. Very nice riposte, and they're going to be able to get Turtle hit with the turret, but he stays alive. Now down to Stixxay in the bottom. It is mayhem for Chronologic Gaming right now. They're going down across the board. HuHi looks to pick one up, shifts in, but now doesn't have a cap closer, and Turtle may be able to just walk out of this one. Throws his flash down just to be sure, and HuHi now gets back and roams lane to lane to find himself picking up nothing.
And Immortals find a gigantic advantage in this early game here. 2,000 gold up, 6 minutes in the game. Whew. At this point, you're like, all right, man, this is my third cannon minion wave. This is great.
Right.
You know, I haven't missed a cannon yet. It's like, no, they haven't missed a kill. They've killed five members of CLG. Absolute disaster here for CLG in this early game, and they were trying to control it. But Immortals get the lane swap, and you can see two levels up for Huni in this mid lane, the level 6 already out for Pobelter, and he is sitting on 1,000 gold. He can upgrade again and get even closer to that completed hex core. Let's see this again, because Darshan's level 2. Darshan wants to hit level 3, and what happens is he'll hit level 3, but he'll hit it right after he ends up getting stunned. He wanted his riposte before that. So he's looking for the level up. Goes and hits some minions. Aphromoo walks too far forward. His magical journey is already used to get to the other side. Instead of walking away, gets hit. And right here, hits three afterwards, and then he riposts to try and get the movement speed away. But he doesn't even go straight up. He ends up kind of going back and forth there, looking for the vitals, looking for the movement speed. And then, yeah, it's another kill.
He tried to get that off in the attack, right? Hit back, but he also drew aggro from all of those caster minions, which didn't make it any easier. He probably knew he was dead to rights and trying to get that last bit of damage out for HuHi. But messy right now for Chronologic Gaming. It's hard to come back from that. We saw the early lanes go down in favor of Immortals first. They're able to act on things just a little bit quicker, and it seems like they have a read on this game throughout the two-game series already, and they are putting that to work now.
Yeah, Darshan's pretty much out of this game right now. He's 33 CS down. Mm-hmm. It's only going to get a little bit worse here, and you can see Immortals are trying to starve him because they're having Reignover come around the top side and push him out. So they want this to die to the turret, and they want Darshan to pick up nothing. He's got 11 CS right now, and that entire wave just goes over to Xmithie. Xmithie picks it up.
Since he went down in the top lane, he had about 10 there. So you see, through that replay and through everything, he's got one more CS since we've watched that. It is going to be very, very tough for him, and Huni's going to keep that pressure on, knowing his advantage. Immortals not letting go either, but this will definitely be a tribute to Chronologic Gaming's defense if they're able to turn this one around on its head.
Yeah, they definitely keep Huni in that top side. Both Stixxay and Aphromoo are trying to chip away at that turret. But it's a 2-on-1, and it's Lissandra who does have decent wave clear, and they have to do a 2-on-3 in the bot side because Fiora's wave clear just pretty much non-existent. So
yeah.
Xmithie is there for helping and assisting in that.
Now you almost wish you had the Tristana as well on that lane.
Yeah, a little bit.
Jhin's going to not be able to get too close with Huni just on the other side. So their turret war is going to be a very hard fight as well if they keep it like this.
God, this feels awful as a top laner. Three levels down, your turret's going down faster than turret on the opposite side of the map. Oh, he goes back in.
Oh, the flash. Emperor's Divide actually does not come out there in the right direction. Nicely done by Pobelter to get himself out of the way.
Still, that turret goes down.
Yep.
And that top turret, still over half HP here for Immortals. Not able to crack it. The wave clear of the lissandra just causing problems. And the fact he's level 7. And here's another thing on top of it, right? Is Huni is getting solo EXP under this turret.
Yeah.
Darshan is getting zoned from the turret. And even when he does pick up experience, he's splitting it with Xmithie.
Exactly. Not making things any easier. This game's going to have to go quite a while for Darshan to get himself back up to fighting. It looks like Immortals is going to go ahead and use that map control to start picking up objectives here, going by the book, one after the other. They're going to drop some turrets. When they can't get a turret, they're going to start dropping CLGs and just objective map resources. And right now, with CLG's jungle basically cleaned out and just respawning, Immortals is going to do just that. They back up into their own, and we'll be back for more in just a second. Teleport is up for Huni, and he's finally approaching that top turret.
Yeah, he can do a lot here, though. He has his ultimate. He's close to that Rod of Ages. He's actually probably going to back right now and pick it up. He has enough gold to do so. Mm-hmm. And there he goes. 10-minute Rod of Ages in a lane swap.
So looking at Darshan, how changed does his build become now? Or is he still forced
still
to go
for
all
it.
Damage? You
yep.
just have to?
You have to do it. You have to go for the Black Cleaver, the CDR. If you don't get that and you start going tanky and get like a Sunfire or something, you're absolutely useless.
Kind of write it off there.
Yeah, you're even worse than before. Because she does true damage, right? So your whole goal is to kind of kill them before they kill you.
Right.
And she needs to scale it with AD. It was one of the nerfs to hers. The vital damage started to scale more with AD than just flat out having the ability to build tank third item.
Oh, just five full minion waves behind Huni, who sits patiently waiting in the brush next to him. Look at that gold disparity.
This could be the problem, though. If Huni ends up going too fast, or if Darshan tries to check the bush, be a big problem. He checks it.
Oh, frozen tomb to start off. Darshan's actually going to say, yeah, you want to take a little bit of the fight? I have somebody behind me. And he does kind of get the mind game on Huni. Huni's right to go back. Xmithie was a bit off, but it was definitely Darshan trying to press his luck on that one. Grand Challenge is down. I don't think they're going to be able to get the death on Huni. Quickly flashes himself out of that one. Nice try by Xmithie, though. CLG is really trying to get their hands dirty here, even though they know they're behind, and they're actually still trying to get that over to Darshan, regardless of how far behind he is.
Exactly. They need to help him out, though.
Yeah.
He needs to get this CS. They'll walk towards this turret. They're getting the blue buff away. But on the top side, they're probably going to trade turrets here. Oh, but no, they're pulling. This pulls HuHi and Xmithie back to the mid lane because Pobelter was putting pressure on it. So they actually might just flat out lose this top turret.
Well, things look like they're almost going good in the bot lane. Things are going bad in mid. Can CLG turn this one around? Ooh. They do. Quite a few resources to take down Pobelter, but it's much needed breathing room on the map to figure out what they can do next.
Those soldiers just slammed him into Gragas' belly. That looked absolutely painful. And HuHi now gets to clear out a wave. And then they got top turret. So overall, Immortals, they're trading one for about 800 gold.
Yep. Oh, I was going to say just on the outside of the knockup, but he still gets in on HuHi. And look at the tank already from him. Just a little bit of shield from Adrian allows Reignover to do some frontline damage. Looks like they'll slowly pressure onto this. Wildturtle taking a few turret shots all game. He just wants to remember how much it hurts. How tanky am I? Oh, that's right. I'm the AD carry. Not so much.
You can do the test.
Just a quick test. How much damage do I do? How much damage do I take? Okay, we're ready. We're calibrated.
Yeah, another really interesting thing here is that that cull from Wild Turtles very close to paying off, so it's just another advantage going out for them. Kind of to thin the wave out here and do a little bit of damage. Nobody was low. And HuHi off on the side, though, or Huni off on the side, looking for a kill.
Reignover had already left that position, but Huni, he's ready to fight 2v1. And Wild Turtle firing the Essence Barrage, or True Shot Barrage, I should say, over the shoulder of Huni to pick himself up a kill and assist for three of his teammates. Is Immortals is finding a little bit of what they want in every place that they go. CLG trying to defend. Immortals will find one kill and the turret. Seems like CLG may need to just activate something of their own instead of continue receiving Immortals' aggression.
Yeah. It's Huni's red buff. No.
Yeah. It's going to be hard. They're getting rid of everything on CLG's side that they can fight back with.
Yeah. Take everything, even if it goes over to your top laner and he's a mage. Just make sure that you're starving the resources of CLG, and that's what Immortals are doing. They have an Ocean Drake to their name. Mm-hmm. Of course, it's just one, so it's a little bit of regen for them. But I think that the big factors here are just those early game skirmishes and the fact that they were able to pick those fights just got them so far ahead so early on. And they got Darshan very far behind, so he's still playing catch up now. He's much closer, though, almost hitting that level 9. Still 1,400 gold down, though.
Well, these games can definitely teach you a lot about how you play in the early game, especially when you're down this far. Usually you don't see this kind of deficit in the early part of the game, and if you do, if it's a scrim, usually you restart, right? You'll say, okay, that's not as good. So it may not be that much playtime under a 7,000 gold deficit this early in the game, or more from previous.
Yeah, a lot of scrim culture has actually changed, though, since the last split. Before it was always, oh, we had a bad fight early game,
right.
Let's just remake. Teams are now playing it out. And if you don't play it out and they really want to, it's like Immortals are like, you know, we have to learn how to close a game out.
Right.
Right.
Exactly.
So if they get 7K up early and the other team's like, well, we want to remake, it's like, well, we don't want to scrim you anymore.
This right? is true.
And when you're in the top of the standings, like Immortals, like Envy, like TSM, you get to make those demands. If you say scrims are at 3:34, they're going to show up at 3:34.
That's always good, though. Given a random time, it makes people think. Makes me think. Got to use those brain powers.
They don't do that, but they could.
14 seconds on Infernal Drake. That's something they can dictate. They have the strength in this game to make CLG either talk to talk or walk the walk and try for this Infernal Dragon. 3 seconds up, you can see how much coverage the Immortals has in this bottom side of the map, and it looks like it's going to be walk the walk for CLG as they're forced to give this one up. And smart move as well. Only two dragons into the game, and we see Stixxay trying to control a few waves around the map. CLG is kind of touch and go, trying to feel whether they can actually put their foot in the door and get their lead back.
Oh, they're pinging this top side though, so this is not going to be a Rift Herald going over to CLG.
Right.
The Infernal Drake comes through, the pings, because I mean, that's their Rift Scuttler, so they knew that was going on. Let me check the gold here. 1,700 for Pobelter, so could back, upgrade his Hex Core one more time, or start going towards that Rylai's. I think he'll go for that Rylai's this early on when people are still on their brown bag boots. I think it's definitely the time to do it.
Can't go fast yet.
Yeah, and then you go even slower.
Minion wave crashing into the turret, but nobody else is there to respond besides Xmithie to put any damage on it. It was slow going for Stixxay in the top lane, still slow going for Darshan in the bottom, but plus side is Immortals actually have let up that aggression. They found a little bit of it in mid, but Darshan's been able to get himself farmed up. If they can find the picks and the not disengages, but kind of throwing the team around, displacing the team, the Gragas ultimate, the Emperor's Divide, and maybe a Tempter's Fate to start it off could be what they need. Here they try that pressure on mid again.
Looking for Stixxay.
Immortals is ready. Chaos Storm goes out. The flash in from Reignover, and they find Stixxay. We talked a bit about that little immobility on Jhin, and it does cost him his life. That's going to be a double kill now onto HuHi. Aphromoo very low, looking for a binding on the backside. Oh, it's staying
another
in, trying to do what he can for the team, but it just keeps him in range for Pobelter. Turtle, Arcane shifts in, goes for another one as the Grand Challenge is still on him. And they're able to take down Adrian as a trade back. Turtle on the side of the base, he usually is with about a few hundred health.
Yeah,
playing crazy. The shell is on, so he's safe.
Reignover is going to be a bro. Tank the turret for him for a little bit.
Seems like there's things that always happen. Going for the Nexus, Turtle have a Quadra. If he's below 200 health, he's got a Rocket Jump or Flash over the other base's wall and be in a dangerous spot. Let's see this one again.
Have a little awkward moment afterwards. Like, I need help, guys. I didn't think I'd get this far. But yeah, Pobelter just does so much damage.
Ooh.
The speed up from Adrian allows him to get through. and also the fact he auto-attacked for more speed, uses the Ghost, does an immense amount of damage there with the Chaos Storm and the Death Ray, both parts of it hitting Stixxay, blows him up. Huhi actually shoves Huni into Aphromoo, and also puts himself in danger, and then the ultimate comes through from Huni to slow down, and then Pobelter walks up and gets the triple kill there. Pobelter has just been on fire this series, even in that loss.
Yeah.
Early game, was doing fantastically. Xmithie, good barrel. Has the runic echoes, blows up,
yep.
Almost kills multiple people there.
Seems like fights are getting very hectic. Small things, Aphromoo ignited Reignover there, very tanky as the team was kind of focusing to the left. So Ignite almost went to waste on Reignover as he was tanking the turret. Just little things here that can be cleaned up, but they all happen so quickly. You really don't have time to talk about them just yet. You just hope that here, Darshan, the guy that's been playing off the ball for CounterLogic Gaming, is doing enough in the side lanes. He's only about 15 CS behind now.
Yeah.
He may be missing the 4 assists that Huni has found within fighting, but he's getting himself up to a point where he may be a nuisance here for Huni in the side lane.
Yeah, he's finally going to have his Black Cleaver completed mm-hmm. when he goes back, but he's still 1,200 gold down.
Yeah.
And honestly, sure, he's 1,200 gold down behind Huni, but Pobelter is at 9,000 gold, and the highest person on CLG is 6,600.
We'll see how it plays out. Frozen Tomb goes down. Grand Challenge has time a bit to wear off.
More.
He's gonna get the other side of it. Can he get one more dash?
Oh,
and Darshan has the mana, and he 1v1 Huni down.
And that last vital appearing on that side, and Huni not protecting a vital
yeah,
against the
wall. Yeah, the farther side. Woo. Very nicely played by Darshan. You can see this game has not gotten to his mentality yet, and he still knows they can find the 2-1 victory here over Immortals. Immortals really trying to block that from happening here, continuously being aggressive and still denying resources from CounterLogic Gaming. Another one over to Pobelter. Like you said, he has been very strong on this Viktor. Both games that he's played now, Vlad to Viktor, have been extremely strong.
Yeah, and I was talking about what items he's going to get. Well, he backs and he gets both. So
he's at that
gigantic Viktor power spike that you hope for around 26 minutes.
Yeah.
And it's the one where your ultimate is faster and then your ultimate slows people. So the Chaos Storm right now is going to decimate CLG.
Whoa!
Like that.
You don't say.
Yeah.
You
and
don't.
It gets to run with him, and it's a little bit faster than him too, even with Ghost on.
Oh. It's like, listen to my damage, and you're gone. Half a second. 10-4. These are the bloodbaths that Aphromoo was having nightmares about, that Immortals would start in their series. 40.6 to 31.6K. Immortals continues to grow their lead here. Really, the hesitation was only letting Darshan get big, and I think they realized the mistake by letting that happen just a few seconds ago when he took down Huni.
Yeah, exactly. But still, large advantage here for Immortals. Darshan. He's gonna have Reignover right on top of him. He's not looking.
Kind of watch. Might just been watching Huni on his map there as he scrolled down to the bot side. You saw a delayed reaction. And Huni's gonna say, if you keep him there long enough, I'll be there to participate. Reignover is able to get the red really without any trouble. A little contest from Darshan, but he is back to farming waves. Like you said, Black Cleaver finished. A team add up now. He'll be able to clear those waves a bit more, but that means they're farther from him faster. Not farther, he pushes them a lot quicker. They got to use their time very, very well on the side of CLG.
It's what he wants to do, though, especially against Lissandra, who just has high wave clear as well. So Huni will try to shove it out, and then Darshan needs to answer and continue to push, because Huni wants to shove and then leave. Darshan wants to shove and stay.
Dragon control, Herald control, really all going over to Immortals throughout these series.
Mm-hmm.
I think there was a Mountain Drake that CounterLogic Gaming was able to pick up throughout this, but... this is very, very big.
Turtle.
Nice hit. That meat was able to connect. They also grab the barrels. Turtle can't dodge left or right quick enough. They clean one up, but CLG is repairing right now, so this doesn't get them too far. They're just able to continuously now safely place wards and figure out what Immortals wants to do next. That was both summoners from Turtle, so he gets a bit more dangerous in positioning now and for the next 5 minutes.
Both summoners from Turtle, and Turtle was just trying to do the scuttle crab, and Xmithie actually just was very clever about that, came from the Fog of War, and then hit him in, so it wasn't really a chance for Wild Turtle to flash and get out of there.
Right.
At least before his fate was sealed. And Pobelter looks like he's going towards Zonias or Rabadons.
He's going to be real big after he completes whatever he has. Like you said, with 1,500 on him.
Zonya's doesn't really build out of that anymore, so Seeker's Arm Guard and Fiendish Codex, not this large rod. My bad.
It's okay. I forgive you.
I don't play mages.
Oh, history repeating itself here in the bot lane. Frozen Tomb onto himself. And it looks like it may not be enough. A quick W.
He's got flash.
And a claw out. Huni's flash is down, but he doesn't decide to go for it under the turret. Too much slow, too much control from that Lissandra.
Yeah, Darshan wanted to flash and get that vital, and he's going to go for it anyway.
He goes under the turret. Can he get him when he's buying? Oh, the potion. Not quick enough. And also too much damage from a ramped up turret there and a few extra shots. Huni does get a bit of a shutdown for his team there with that gold. Two kill, so not too shabby.
Oh, Reignover caught out on the side, but still going to get the assistance from Adrian, and yeah.
CLG playing this game like there was never any deficit in the early game. Going hard onto Reignover here. Is there a follow-up on Xmithie's ultimate? He's looking to displace the team. Maybe Adrian first. Pobelter right around the back. He's able to just walk up. There should be a front line, but CLG is so focused on these kills, they're leaving everything behind them open. There's nobody to save the squishies, and Pobelter's going to take full advantage of that along with the rest of the team. This could be an ace onto CLG, but Darshan coming from the base will not allow that to happen. It's not possible, but Immortals, the possibility for Baron is very real now.
Pobelter gets a ton of criticism all the time about being the weakest link on this squad. I mean, even you go back to the votes for All-Star, it was like, okay, all of Immortals plus Jensen. He's the guy that was left out. And Pobelter's consistent. Pobelter's the guy that they can rely on. Reignover gave him an advantage over Huni early, and he was able to drive it home. Pobelter is the guy that can rely on.
Let's see this fight one more time.
Reignover goes over, but it's really just, he's super tanky. They're not able to do enough, and then Pobelter's like, you want to go through here? Not a chance. Blows up HuHi, and wildturtle from the opposite side just gets the slowdown, and then Reignover gets knocked into Aphromoo. He's helping. And then Pobelter with the chase down there, the dodge. Quick feet there, and then four members go down, and the Baron goes over to Immortals.
Uh-oh. Just in the bottom left cam, we see Aphromoo having some trouble. A flash out. Huni actually just got that flash back up, but he's loving the fact that he has Baron. Does not want to lose it for the side lanes. Mm-hmm. It'll take a flash over losing Baron.
Yeah, keep some people on this side. Allow your top lane to shove in. Pobelter's going to show up, and he is 7-1-3. Death cap completed.
Yep.
It is 26 minutes in. He has three items, and he has 750 AP. It's ridiculous.
Always wondered, Pobelter kind of almost took a backseat on teams, maybe. That's why it always came out and people would say that. But you always wondered, where would this best ZNA come from? Where was this guy that played all these things in solo queue that kind of made highlights?
Yeah, well,
and it's still in there.
Yeah, on CLG, he wasn't really a big standout player for them.
Right,
but
there was utility, there was Lulu most of the time.
When he was on struggling squads like Winter Fox and Evil Geniuses, it was like Pobelter would play some of those assassins. He would be able to go off.
Yeah.
And Immortals, he's not really the guy that has to do that, right? They have Huni, who's favored those carries, but he can do it. but he can't do that.
He will be one of the guys to try and do it and sometimes get himself in a sticky situation. 50 seconds on the clock for him that time for getting his hands a little too dirty. Darshan not starting this fight, does not have the upper hand when Huni comes in with the damage first. And it looks like the grand challenge is up, but he cannot challenge. We see Stixxay going down on the other side of the map. HuHi will get himself a quick claw kill.
That Rift Herald buff flying all the way past. Just an auto.
Oh, true. The auto.
Yeah. It flew all the way down. It actually looked like it was a Q that was like tracking him. It was like, nope, that's just an auto.
Sun Disc up. Turtle happily taking this one down as HuHi plays a little range defense with the soldiers. I don't know if it's going to be enough.
Turtle really wants to thatcher it.
For a one-man fight, it seems to be enough. Adrian's like, I can't heal you. I can only shield you. Please don't play like this. They're going to head to the mid lane. Seems like that's where most of Immortals' pressure is as Xmithie tries to put up a wall of defense with the rest of the members.
Yeah, Reignover does take up that turret, though. And Huni, yep, hits and runs. He's been doing that all game long. Huni, you know, he's been dying a lot in these games. He's just putting his champion at risk constantly. It's causing some pressure, but there have been some errors on his part. He was largely ahead. We're talking like 70 CS, and then fell a bit behind when Darshan 1v1'd him. He got his revenge finally, but the rest of Immortals, they're definitely running away with this lead.
Yep.
15,000, 14,000.
They seem to clamp down a little bit more.
Yeah.
They saw Darshan get Huni twice, and they said, we actually need to make more pressure. We'll see this kill one more time.
Ooh, too far forward there, and Wild Turtle just combos him down. Absolutely brutal. Super quick. Oh, yeah, Wild Turtle has one more item to build, and Stixxay has three inventory slots to fill. So
yep.
It's a big difference.
Yep. You could say just a tad there.
Just a tad.
Huni back to the bottom lane now. He has the needlessly large rod as well as he continues to build himself up. You're also right about Pobelter. He got a Rabadon, so no worries there. You called it. 17-7. It's going to be about 15,000 gold lead right now for Immortals here. The worry is if they don't close it soon. How are they using this gold lead? Darshan's going to be attacked as the claw out from Huni could put him to safety. Remember, that flash is down from the last engage, but does he actually make it last long enough for the team to get here? They do, and Darshan is running the wrong way as he also goes down in the fight, trying to get back onto Huni. Immortals now with just about free reign in the base. It's only Xmithie, HuHi, and Stixxay with the say.
Yeah, and they're pushing the bottom side as well, so if Immortals want to, they can rotate towards the bottom and get another inhibitor, because this wave is continuing to be pushed up. And they're trying to make a play.
And Burst of Eye goes through. They should be able to drop Huni. Really, all they lose here is side pressure. The four members of Immortals are very strong and strong enough to stay in the base. Their confidence deems so as well. And it looks like they're going to put a bid on. Xmithie flashes himself in. He is going for broke on this one with the ultimate. The pushback isn't enough. It doesn't displace enough members of Immortals. And they're still packed together, ready to deliver the power. Now they're going to go into Aphromoo before he can journey safely to the fountain. And now they are looking at the Nexus turrets. Just a little past their second game win of 26 minutes, 30 minutes onto the Nexus turret here. And they are looking to put the final touches on. 27 seconds on to Xmithie, 20 for Aphromoo. Three members of Counterlogic Gaming doing all they can to deliver enough stopping power to keep the Nexus alive against Immortals. And so far, they're able to deter them enough. The four members of Immortals cannot break through just yet. And it looks like defensive Aphromoo will be here. However, CLG's base is turning into shambles.
Exactly. They're pinging towards the top lane now. Immortals, they want to take this. Huni TP's back in. And here comes Reignover as well with the ultimate. And they're looking for the end.
Huni flying straight in. Reignover's already there. Grand challenge onto him, but they can't get the rest of the challenge down. He stays alive, and so does the challenge. Now from Immortals to CLG. Will you be able to stop us in one of our final pushes as CLG and Immortals go for broke? It's going to be in the favor of Immortals. They will not go down in this series, and it is the bloodbath to end it all. 26-9, 30 minutes in. Immortals take the series over CounterLogic Gaming.
And Immortals able to stay.